Well, good evening, everyone. My name is Michael McNeely, and I'm asking for your vote to become the next chairman of the Georgia Republican Party. A little bit about me. I grew up in Renz, Georgia, a little rural town near Augusta, Georgia. Grew up in the home of Alec and Francis McNeely, who at 9 months old adopted me, so the right to life issue is very important to me. Everything about my life has been focused on God and country. I was in the Boy Scouts and the Proud Eagle Scout, served in the Georgia Army National Guard, was a police officer for 14 years, and currently an executive with Georgia Juvenile Justice. In the party, I worked my way up through the ranks, first volunteering for the re-election campaign of Governor Sonny Perdue. Went to my county, helped get Republicans elected and grow our party by doing the things that we all do, waving signs, making phone calls, and going door to door. I was vice chair, third and first vice chair in my county, served as the political director for the Georgia Young Republicans, served as the Georgia Black Republican Council chair, and now is first vice chair of the Georgia Republican Party. Everything about what we do in our party is about service, and I'm here to serve. We've got a lot that we can do. We've got a lot that's broken that must be fixed. But there's a world out there, a lot of people, a lot of families around the state that want to hear from us, and we have to be able to message our conservative principles and how they apply to people. We have to grow our party with people that aren't with us today, but could be, if we unite as our grassroots, if we work together in all 159 counties. And I look forward to doing that with you in a new role, hopefully. But either way, I'm going to be Michael McNeely. I'm going to be a conservative. And I think that we've got a lot of great things we can do, and I look forward to that. Ladies and gentlemen, we're at a critical point. Our state is red, but in order for it to remain red, we've got to do a lot of fundamental things. We've talked about several of them tonight. Not spending more than you bring in, being a fiscal conservative, being able to message to those donors, but also to individuals that are not with us today. When we leave that convention on June 3rd, what will we be saying to the men and women outside of the walls of that convention? Who will be able to be that visionary and that chief spokesman for this party? Who will be able to work with each of you to grow our party and to strategize into a future? Who has been with you for years, working with you at all levels of this party? When we talk about who the next chairman is going to be, we've got to look at all of the issues and not get tunnel vision on one. Because if we're going to grow and if we're going to continue to be relevant, we've got to be able to check multiple boxes. And you've got four men before you, and you've got to make that choice. I submit to you that I'm that person to work with you to do it. And I humbly ask for your support in becoming the next chairman. Not so that Michael McNeely has all the answers, but with what I bring to the table and your experience and background together, we defeat a liberal agenda on the other side of the aisle. We grow our party and we articulate a message that resonates with everyone. Thank you for your time tonight. Thank you for what you're doing in your party. God bless you.